compression fractures, because it's pretty common, right? Compression fractures. And how common are they? Can we maybe use that little model to show our viewers maybe what we're talking about?
Yeah, so I think this is gonna give you a better idea of what's happening with the bones. So most commonly when a compression fracture occurs, it occurs in this portion of the vertebral body. Okay, that's
the gray section.
The part that's in front. That's right, the gray section.
Okay.
So the disc is what we're seeing as the tan section here, and the bone is the gray section. And the bone's composed of several components. There are some in the front, there are some pieces in the back. What we're most concerned with is the front portion of the bone, which is involved in a compression fracture. And what happens in this type of fracture is that the bone squishes down on itself because the bone is not able to support the weight of the body. So this piece of bone compresses down, and because of that, it results in significant pain.
But that's a lot of pain.
Yeah, and then this is a great model because this also shows what we were talking about before with all the different etiologies or causes of pain. So when Brian talked about the compression, that's the vertebral pain. This side here, if you see the bones move, and those are the joints. So any inflammation in those joints that stops that freedom of movement would cause pain with each movement. And then as Brian said, the disc or the cushions between. And if you look, we're standing all day and gravity's pulling you down, and over age, that these discs become less, what we call dehydrated, or have less fluid within the disc. And that causes the bones to get closer and closer. So either the bones could be rubbing on each other and giving you pain, or back here is where the spinal canal runs in the nerves. And if this disc pushes back a little bit, then that disc could be touching the nerve. And all it has to do is barely touch it, and it could cause a significant amount of pain. So as you see, the spine, while it looks quite simple, there's a lot of different ways that just one little thing going wrong could cause a lot of pain.